Good morning, this Thursday the 30th of September. I'm Paulina Peters, a market analyst at Bell Direct. It's great to be with you. Well, yesterday we saw the ASX 200 extend its poor performance in September, falling about 1%. This dragged the market to a four-month low, and it was rising bond yields and a fall in the iron ore price that put pressure on all sectors, with tech stocks taking the biggest hit. It was only the consumer staples and utility sectors that were able to close slightly in the green. All four of the big banks closed in the red, while gold miners managed to gain despite the gold price sliding. Now looking to the US, the market was mixed. The Dow Jones managed to add 90 points and the S&P 500 slightly rose about 0.16%. But it was the tech-heavy Nasdaq that came under pressure, falling 0.24% following the volatile 10-year Treasury yield. Defensive stocks performed well, like Boeing, which rose 3.1% to be the best performer in the Dow. Separately, the House on Wednesday also passed a bill to suspend the US debt ceiling as the US heads towards a first ever default with no clear solution in sight. Now, what to watch today? Well, following a mixed session on Wall Street, the futures are suggesting the Aussie share market will open 0.32% higher this morning. In terms of economic news, building permits will be released today. Consensus expects total dwellings approved in Australia to decline 5% after the 8.6% drop in the prior month. Some companies that are paying their latest dividends include Bendigo and Australia Bank, BEN, CSL, Fortescue Metals Group, FMG, Newcrest Mining, NCM, and Ramsay Healthcare, RHC. Separately, Westgold Resources, WGX, goes ex-dividend today. And in terms of the most traded stocks by Bell Direct clients yesterday, they included Mineral Resources, MIN. Its shares fell 5.6% yesterday, following the decline in the iron ore price, which is driven by power outages in China and lingering concerns over Evergrande's default. Other highly traded stocks included ANZ, Tabcorp, TAH, Regis Resources, RRL, and Brambles, BXB. Now moving to commodities, the oil price edged lower on Wednesday to about US$75 a barrel. This comes as US crude inventories rose more than expected, despite OPEC planning to maintain its deliberate approach to adding more supply to the market despite strong worldwide demand. The uranium price rose 5%, while on the flip side, the lithium price fell 5%. The gold price fell following the dollar rising and due to the growing confidence that the Fed will soon begin winding down its economic support measures. Now to end on some trading ideas for your consideration. Bell Potter has rated iron ore exploration and development company GenMine, GEN, as a speculative buy, with a price target of 44 cents. The company has a pipeline of projects in the Republic of Gabon in Central West Africa. The most advanced of these is the Baniaka project, which brings together a rare combination of a high-grade product, scalability, renewable hydroelectric power supply, and a stable African mining jurisdiction. Bell Potter believed the combination of these factors makes GEN's project portfolio a strong candidate for Chinese state-owned enterprises, SOEs, aiming to meet China's objective of controlling an increased proportion of its iron ore requirements and diversifying supply away from Australia. GEN closed yesterday at 17 cents, which implies about 159% share price growth. To end, bullish trading signals have been identified in Insurance Australia Group, IAG, Resolute Mining, RSG, and Perseus Mining, PRU, according to Trading Central. And that's it for today. I'm Paulina Peters with Bell Direct. Stay safe and happy trading.